يسألون
Children who are going to the mainstream schools, who are seeing the Christmas celebrations, they may not openly admit that they are feeling affected, but by Allah, teaching children, I've come across this much, that they definitely are affected from the mahol which they see. You cannot help but driving past a house, and if you have a few kids with you, or you're walking them in the street, our masjid is here and the house is in front, all lit up, what are they going to do? They're going to stand and admire. While they're waiting outside, they're looking at that house, admiring the house. It looks colourful, all manners of flashing lights, it looks attractive. Which young heart will not be linked and pulled towards this thing? Am I right or wrong? Our children will be affected from this thing. Because they are seeing this, their heart is naturally going towards it. When we are living in this mahol, ask yourself a question. What did you do for Eid al-Adha? The same thing we do year in, year out. We gather together, maybe cook some rice, some pilau, maybe cook a meat curry, a chicken curry, a few samosas, a few kebabs, some tandoori chicken, some chutney, some salad, some falooda, some ice cream, some gulab jamuns. What? Then what? Sit down and we talk to discuss about money, wealth. Who's doing what? Allah forbid, even ghibat starts in the gathering. This is our Eid. People gather around for one day and they think, okay, Baniyoji, what's happening with your life? What are you doing with yourself? We start talking, oh, did you hear this? Everyone have a good listen to what this ghibat I'm about to say. Is this the condition of our Eid? I questioned a number of my students. I said, right, tell me, what did you do for Eid? Nothing, sat at home. What did you do? Sat at home. Number three, sat at home, visited family. MashaAllah, we understand the need of visiting. Don't we think for a moment, subhanAllah, do something for the sake of Allah? Islam hasn't stopped us and made it forbidden. We just think, subhanAllah, wallahu alam what we are thinking. But we have to think a bit differently for the sake of our children. If we take a little bit of time out, now, okay, we are not saying to light up the whole house, but at least decorate the house, let them know that something is going on. There's something of importance which is taking place. Let them go out, start with... Already tell them in 10 days time there will be Eid, in 9 days time there will be Eid, in 8 days time it will be Eid. Slowly, slowly, we are getting them worked up, we are getting them emotional, we are getting them anticipating the day of Eid. But what happens? Eid. Wake up in the morning, okay, let me get my salwar kameez on, go to the masjid, do a 3 hug, go home, eat some food and go out with the boys in the evening to smoke some weed. Is this our days? Is this what we are doing? This is the reality, this is what's happening on the ground. Because our boys and girls, they are not finding deen attractive. Who said Eid cannot be attractive? Who said Eid cannot be fun? We don't take time out realizing that our children are becoming infected, affected. We don't sit down to ask them, what? How do you feel? No gifts, nothing. Ask each and every child, 10 children. They'll say the same thing. I've got £10. I've got £15. I've got £20. I've got £5. And they're saying, oh, well, it must be something to do with Islam then. Maybe Islam is boring because that's how it seems anyway. Allahu Akbar. Islam hasn't taught that. We need to just do a bit more of an effort. Why not wrap presents so they can see? Why not put it in a bag? So you can, that's your Eid present, you've got 10 more days. I asked one boy, so I asked him, I said, have you got a PS3? And he said, no, my birthday is happening in 3 weeks, my mum says she'll buy it for my birthday. And then I thought to myself, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. That thing which was not even Islamic, that thing which was nothing to do with the deen. But so we are just blindly following as well. Everyone else is doing it, so we have to do it as well. So if everyone's going to blindfold them, jump themselves off a cliff, we'll do it as well. We'll use the excuse, everyone was doing it, so I was doing it. Does this work in the court of Allah? I was doing it because everyone else was doing it. Why not use that money and spend it on Eid? And say, for your Eid you will get an iPod, for your Eid you will get a PS3, for your Eid you will get this. To make it attractive. And that's why Allah gave us two.